Hello, my name is Dimitri and I'm an application engineer in Typhoon HIL. Today I will show you how to simulate interturn short circuit in an induction machine. This demonstration will be shown on induction losses calculation and thermal example model, where induction machine with squirrel cage is used. First, I will explain how to set up your model in order to simulate interturn short circuit. By going into the properties of induction machine with squirrel cage, in the last tab, we have several fault-related properties, first of which enables fault simulation. In the second property, we can choose the fault type, and in the third, we can choose the winding on which the short circuit will happen. There are two parameters of the fault, severity factor and fault resistance, provided to the machine in the vector form. Since in this demonstration, we want to show how will the machine behave when the interturn short circuit happens during normal operation, then these parameters will be provided from SCADA, where we will change them in real time. Before simulation, let me explain what are severity factor and fault resistance. Severity factor is a parameter that describes how much of the winding is affected by the fault. Its value is provided in relative units, from 0 to 1. 0 means that path of the short circuit starts and ends at the same end of the winding, while for non-zero values, second point of the short circuit moves towards the other end of the winding, where 1 means that the whole winding is shorted. Resistance of the fault represents the resistance of the short circuit path. For this purpose, we've added a new tab in SCADA for interturn short circuit fault, where we can choose the values for fault resistance and severity factor, and on pressing this button, the fault occurs. During normal operation, we can see that currents are balanced and that the IGBT junction temperatures are normal. However, when the fault occurs, several values will become unbalanced or simply too high. I will now induce the fault and we can see what will happen. First of all, speed will become much more unstable and the IGBT junction temperatures will rise and also currents will become highly unbalanced. When we look at the currents in SCADA, then we can observe how this fault has impacted the currents in every phase.